So, now you should design the type of fire alarm you will use. Addressable system or conventional system, okay? And as we mentioned before or in a previous video, the main difference between the addressable and the conventional two things. First thing is that we are using zones in conventional system, okay? We divide building two zones. If we have here a FACB fire alarm of conventional type, okay? We are divide the building two zones, okay? And each zone have a line, okay? And on this zone line, we install our devices, okay? Our alarm devices or the protection level devices, the sensors, smoke sensor, gas sensor, heat sensor, beam sensor, okay? Also, we have another loop here, another zone here, okay, with its sensors. If we have a fire here and this sensor detects that we have a fire in this area, the FACB or the control panel shall be notified that we have a fire in this zone, all of this zone, whatever the area of this zone or whatever the coverage area of this zone, okay? Only we know is that we have a fire in this zone or in this area. Specifically where, we don't know. Specifically which sensor creates this alarm, we don't know. All we know is that we have alarm attached to or notified by this loop. Okay, and usually with the conventional panels, we or the alarm level, and I mean the flushers, the bells, and the sirens have a separate line. Okay, so we have a loop or alarm zone line. Okay. And this line is a power line, okay? Power line, and we call it the DC line, okay? And this DC line is connected to bells and sirens and horns and flushers, okay? And in case of we have a fire from any zone connected to the FACB, all the alarm level shall be powered up, so all bells and sirens shall work. Okay, whatever the coverage area of these devices. Okay, maybe we have, or in some advanced control panels, we have more than DC lines, okay? But usually we have only one DC line and multiple zones, okay? And if you have, and for example, if we have two floors building like this, okay? And this building is covered by two zones, we will have only one alarm zone, okay? So this line shall be go to the first floor and the second floor, okay? And any alarm in the building detected by protection zones shall raise an alarm to all the building because we have only one alarm level zone, okay? We have a relay here. Okay, technically we have a relay here, and in case of fire, this relay is closed or connect power to the alarm zone. Okay, so all bells shall be work, all sirens shall work, all horns shall work, all flashers shall work, whatever the fire detected from which zone. Okay, but in FACB, okay, if we have a panel here, we are using loops. okay, and we have a building like this, okay, of several floors, and the loop could cover more than floor, okay, and we have sensors here like this, okay, and each sensor have an address, okay, so in case of fire in a specific area, the FACB shall be notified by that we have a fire, okay, and also this fire is notified by a specific sensor, okay, and we can add a label to this address in the FACB. So in case of fire, we have alarm and we have the sensor address and we have the area name, which is the label attached to the address of this sensor, so the fire team can go directly to the specific area. Okay, so it is not required to cover only one level or one floor by a one loop. The loop could cover several area, several floors. Okay, and also for the alarm, okay, if we have a fire alarm loop here, okay, and I mean bells and horns and flashers, okay, and the DC line start from the FACB and cover the required area and add your alarm devices here, sirens and bells, okay, and in the protection level loop, we add something or a device called control module, and each siren or horn or flasher connected to this control module, so that in case of fire, if we want only a specific bells or horns to work, the FACB shall or shall message a specific control module to raise the alarm. Okay, so we can control the bells to raise up, the horns to work, the flashers to work, because also we have an addressable alarm loop. Okay, so the DC is connected all the time to all the devices, and we control the alarm devices by control modules on the protection level. Okay, so we have some kind of connection between the protection loop and the alarm loop at the same time. Okay, so this is the main difference between the addressable and the conventional. Okay, and you should keep in mind number of devices, and by devices I mean device types. Devices types allowed to connected to one loop. Okay. Usually, if we have a loop or we have a zone, okay, whatever, the zone start from the FACB and goes until the end. At if this is a zone, conventional system, at end of this line we add a resistance called end of loop resistance. Okay. Or end of loop resistance. We use these abbreviations, okay? And in addressable system, the loop starts from the panel and covers the area and come back again to the panel, okay? So we don't have end of loop resistance, okay? Number of devices connected or installed with this zone or with this loop is limited, okay? And usually it doesn't exceed 254 devices per loop, okay? And all of this number of devices, they are not the same type of devices, okay? So according to the manufacturer, the catalog of the panel shall tell you that you should use, for example, 50 smoke detector, 40 heat detector, 2 beam detector, 50 control module, 50 monitor module, okay? So while designing your system and while decide the coverage area and the number of loops you will choose or you will assign, you should keep in mind number of specific devices that shall be connected to this loop, okay? Maybe you are, if we have a building here, okay, and we have a control panel here, okay, and we have a two floors, okay, and you decided to cover this floor by one loop, okay, like this, okay, and while adding the sensors to the rooms and the corridors and the storage and different places in this floor, you figured out that you need 120 smoke detector, okay? And the manufacturer recommendation of for this panel is that the loop smoke devices on this loop shouldn't exceed 60 smoke device per loop. That means that one loop is not enough for this floor, and you will need another loop. Okay, so this is of the most important consideration in your design. Okay, and also for alarm level. Okay, if we have a loop here or the loop of alarm devices, or also the manufacturer will tell you that this loop can stand up with up to 50 pill, okay? And if you need more than this number, you will add another loop, okay? And when you finish your design, you will know, or you will figure out the number of loops you want, and then you will say, I need a 5 loop FACB or 8 loop FACB, and also you should add about 30 to 40% of number of loops as a spare for future installations, okay? This is for the addressable and the conventional system and some consideration while deciding number of loops in your building. Thank you.